can turn the world on with a smile. You can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile. What a secret, and you should know it. Each glance and every little movement you show it.
Love is all around.
Don't need to fake it.
You can have it down.
Why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the show. Today is Thursday, January 17th, and Marc has 537 days left to go in his U.S. prison sentence. That's up until his early release date, 85% of the 5 years, for good behavior, and that would be the furthest we hope that he would be released. But we're planning on getting him home sooner than that, and I'll have more on that in a moment. But a late news that just happened last night, or rather the night before, Marc and his cellmate, who have a triple-celled bunk, got a third cellmate. Now, this is only a 12-by-7 square foot space. In fact, the Bureau of Prisons' own regulations state that you cannot have three people housed in a cell that small, but they've done it anyway, so there are a lot of cells with triple bunks, and finally another person came in. So that was just too tight and too comfortable, and Marc, because he's so loved and gets along with so many people, was able to work out a room change. So he and his cellmate were able to move into a two-man cell where they're now more comfortable. But for us, that's just a reminder of how so many prisoners out there are crammed into very horrible conditions, and even far worse than what Mark's going through, for sure. And we need to remember those people. We need to remember that prisoners are being put away and locked up and deprived of their freedom, deprived of their family and their loved ones and their jobs and everything that they hold dear. So many people are suffering that great injustice. And for us, it's a reminder that when we get Marc home, I know personally I'm going to keep fighting for the rights of prisoners, because they are sometimes the forgotten ones when we're talking about marijuana legalization and drug policy reform. We need to remember a lot of people suffer very horribly in these prison systems, and we need to work for them. So I promise to commit to that. Now, in terms of getting Marc home, he's able to apply for transfer in April with the U.S. government forms, but he already got the Canadian transfer paperwork from his transfer lawyer, and he's filled it out, and today he mailed it back to her, and that means we're getting underway in trying to get Marc home. I'm going to be writing some official letters for you guys to be able to use to send to your member of parliament, or your city councillor, or your congressman, or whomever you would like to reach out to on Marc's behalf. I'm going to have some letters for you to use. And that work is all coming up, and you can stay tuned at freemarc.ca and cannabisculture.com. And this weekend, I'll have Marc's recent blog about the transfer posted online, so you can find out more about the process and how it works, and how last time he was rejected, but this time, hopefully with everyone's support, we can get him home by September, October this year to be released from Canadian prison in mid-December and have him home by Christmas. So it's either going to be under a year or under 2 years we're getting him home, but we need your help to try and make it happen sooner. And again, when he comes home, we'll keep fighting for everybody who's still locked up behind bars. Now, today I got to go to an interesting event. Simon Fraser University held a city conversation. It's a regular event where they talk about different issues, and cannabis was today's issue. And discussing it were Donald McPherson, he's a former drug policy coordinator for the City of Vancouver, but also Cash Heed. Now, Cash Heed is a member of our provincial legislature, and I actually ran against him in 2009 as a BC Green Party candidate. And there was a lot of gang violence and drug prohibition problems happening at that time, and my whole campaign was based on how do we stop the gang violence and prohibition. And I drilled it into his head, and today at the event he even pointed me out and said, thanks for holding me to it. And that was nice to hear, because he has become a strong advocate for legalization and has been working with Stop the Violence BC to spread that message. So even though there's quite a few misconceptions and prohibition myths continued, perpetuated about the harms of high THC and all that, the conversation is discussing prohibition as a failed policy and So if you ever get an opportunity to go to a local event discussing crime or drugs or marijuana or prisons, be sure to go so you can have your voice heard. We had Marius and Jeremiah and Marijuana Man here, and they were able to speak to a number of issues and have a conversation, and that was great. So be sure to support any politician who endorses ending prohibition. That's what we've got to do. We've got to help them see the way things are and the way they need to move forward on ending prohibition and implementing a new system, whatever it may be. Now, I just mentioned about my 2009 BC Green Party campaign, and as I've mentioned in previous videos, I am running for office this year. Coming up, we're having another provincial election, and I'll be the BC Green Party candidate for Vancouver West End. That's here downtown, right with Denman and Davie and Stanley Park, and it's going to be a very interesting race, I think, and I'm just getting underway. I'll be putting together my campaign in the coming week, and you'll be hearing more about that. And if you'd like to support me, check out what my campaign was like 3 years ago. You can go to jodie4mla.ca and you'll be able to see all of the news clippings and the videos and photos and my blog, and see how I ran that campaign, and see how I plan to run my future campaign too. Now I'm going to do the t-shirt draw here. I've got all your entries in the bubble bag as usual, and you can get all sorts of stuff at cannabisculture.com/store. And for you Canadian viewers, you're now able to buy Heady glass from our online store. We've got incredible pieces by some amazing companies and amazing glass blowers. So check it out if you haven't yet. That's a brand new edition online, the Heady glass at Cannabis Culture's online store. And the winner of the t-shirt draw is going to be Alex S. Enjoy watching your show and appreciate everything you are doing. And free Marc. So that's awesome. You are going to win the prize pack, as usual, of the free Marc Emery stickers, the free Marc Emery pin, which we just got back in stock so I can ship them all out, and the free Marc Emery t-shirt, which again you can get at Cannabis Culture. And we have a huge amount of stock of these actually, so the prices are really affordable. You can get them online at cannabisculture.com/store. Show your support, and hopefully we can just have Marc sign your shirt when he gets home, and it'll be a good piece of memorabilia from the days when he was gone. And again, we'll continue fighting when he gets home, and I appreciate all of your support. If you want to enter for next week's giveaway, just send an email to jodie@cannabisculture.com and say prize entry or draw or whatever you want to put, and I'll put you in my folder, and then you go in the bubble bag, and then maybe you'll be the winner next time around. So thanks for tuning in. I'll see you guys next week. Check out cannabisculture.com for all sorts of cannabis news, and pot.tv for regular live shows. And you guys know the drill. Go to freemark.ca and check out his latest blogs and all the other info there. Thanks for tuning in. Take care, everyone. No more drug war.